Hello, how are you today? I'm hi.
Good evening, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Can you hear me?
Hi, teacher. Teacher, good evening.
Hello, good evening. Can you hear me? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Es que no sé por qué siempre me dice, tus altavoces no están funcionando. Y sí está funcionando todo. Okay, well, nice to see you. How was your day? Fine, fine. Yes.
Did you good evening, teacher.
Did you have a good day today? Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Okay, perfect. Perfect, perfect. Well, let's see the attendance first. Tomorrow is Wednesday, right? Let's see, 21st. Okay, Angel Antonio. Angel? Angel, not here. Aristides?
Present.
Denia Guadalupe.
Present.
Nice. Eduardo Ernesto. Eduardo. You're here. Edwin.
Present.
Nice. Fatima Xiomara. Fatima. Fatima, Fatima. Not here. Isabel?
Present.
Great. Luis Mauricio? Luis Mauricio? María Fermelinda?
Present, teacher.
María tiene que ponerse María, oye. Tiene que
vaya.
María, porque sí nos dijeron hoy.
Intenté renombrar, pero no pude. Ya voy a intentar.
Vale, ok. Marisela. Marisela. No guía Marisela. Marlene Elizabeth. Maura Irene. Maura. Nidia.
Present, teacher.
Okay.
We can do present.
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 Ricardo. Baby, Ricardo, no here. Teresa.
Present, este, ya voy a encender la cámara, teacher, que ahorita no puedo. Ya la enciendo.
Ok, Teresa. Walter.
Present, teacher.
Sí.
Se escucha, teacher, no mucho.
Ok, ahora. Yesenia. Okay. Judy?
Present, teacher.
Hey, hello, Judy. Maura, you here, right? Maura?
Present, teacher.
¿En la cama está?
Ricardo. Yesenia. Marlene. Marisela. Luis Mauricio. Fátima. Eduardo Ernesto. Ángel.
Present.
Okay, now I'm good. Well, that's the attendance for today. Let me see. I'm going to share the presentation with you. Let's see. Por andar comiendo pan, se me fue una miguita de pan, así bien feo. Me ha quedado lastimada la garganta. Es que no hay que andar comiendo pan, está bien rico, sí, sí, sí. Ok, let's see, I'm sharing, right, the presentation with you. Let's see. Let's begin with the review of last class yesterday. Let me see one thing. Quiero ver una cosa. Ah, va.
Okay. Yeah.
No veía que me dijera grabando. Va, ok.
Teacher, una
tell me.
Teacher, sorry, una consulta.
Dígame, Denise.
¿Esa presentación no la podría compartir?
No? Ustedes le pueden tomar foto, le pueden tomar captura, pero así toda la presentación no se las puedo compartir.
De acuerdo. Gracias.
Ok. Pero sí le pueden ir tomando foto, pueden irle tomando captura, ¿verdad? Cada uno de los cuadritos. Ok, vamos a ver. Remember yesterday we were talking about countable and uncountable nouns. We said that how much is used with uncountable nouns, right? ¿Qué son uncountable nouns? ¿Quién me dice?
Pronombres incontables, porque no se pueden contar.
Exactly. All those things that I cannot count, right? If I cannot count it, I say, it is uncountable and I use how much. ¿En qué otro caso usamos how much? When talking about talking about what?
Money.
Money, exactly. So when you say how much money do you earn, remember how much you earn per hour? How much money do you make? That I told you, write the answers in your notebook, don't say them. Right. But we can use how much when talking about money. So you say, how much is it? How much is it? How much is a pen? How much is a big pen? How much is a big pen? Give me this. ¿Cuánto vale? How much? 20 cents, 25 cents, something like that.
It is a quarter dollar.
It's a quarter. Okay, it's a quarter, yes. So we can use how much to talk about prices, right? To talk about money. and also to talk about uncountable nouns. So we know time. We know time is not countable, right? So you say, how much time? Dijimos que podemos contar las veces que hacemos algo, right? You say how many times, pero no el tiempo, how much time. How much time does it take you to get to work? Yeah, how much time? How much time does it take you to get to work? ¿Cuánto le lleva? Desde su casa al trabajo. 1 hour, 30 minutes, 20 minutes, 2 hours.
Uh-huh. 30 minutes.
30 minutes. Okay. Y los que trabajan en la casa, 1 minute. 1 minute to get to.
No, 1 minute.
1 minute and a half, right? Okay. Now, how much money did you spend today? Or we can say, how much money we want to change the question. Do you spend on the weekend? ¿Se han fijado que el fin de semana es cuando uno no gana y gasta? Right? Ajá. How much money do you spend on the weekend? How much money do you spend on the weekend? Mm-hmm.
I spend $50
on the weekend. Okay. How much sugar do you like in your coffee? How much sugar do you like in your coffee? Do you like sugar? How much sugar do you like in your coffee?
Mm-hmm. A lot of sugar.
You like a lot of sugar, okay. You can say, well, I like a little sugar. Or I don't like much sugar, right? Okay. How much milk is there in the fridge? Do you have milk in your fridge? In the refrigerator?
Yes.
How much milk is there in your...
A little milk.
Okay, a little bit.
Yes.
Okay. Now, how much television do you watch every week? How much television? How much television do you watch? Do you watch a lot of television? You don't watch much television?
A little?
Okay. You watch a little television.
Little television.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now let's go to the next. No problem here with how much. Yeah. We use how much to ask for questions when we're talking about uncountable nouns, right? Uncountable. Okay. Now, let's see.
Una pregunta, teacher. Cuando usted dijo, how much sugar in your coffee? I can say, I want 2 spoons or a little sugar in my coffee.
Both are okay.
Okay.
2 spoons no me asuste.
Okay.
That's too much sugar. Yeah. You can say, how much sugar do you like in your coffee? I like 1 spoon, 2 spoons. Hay gente que toma un montón de azúcar y puede decir, I like 3 spoons of sugar. Right? Too sweet. Ese es azúcar con café. Okay. Or you
say, I like 2 spoons of sugar in my coffee.
No, that's impossible to drink. Yeah. But little spoons. Like this, or the big ones?
The little spoon.
La sopera.
No, the little.
A little
big one.
Teacher, I have a question about it.
Big.
What if I don't like sugar in my coffee? I can say, I don't like sugar in my coffee, or I don't like any sugar in my coffee. What is the difference?
Both. The difference is that you can use any, usually you use any with negatives, right? And it doesn't matter if you're talking about singular or plural, right? So you can perfectly use any. And you say, I don't like any sugar. O sea, no me gusta nada, nada de azúcar. So it's like giving more emphasis. But you can also say, I don't like sugar in my coffee. No me gusta azúcar. No me gusta el azúcar. Or okay. I like my coffee black. I prefer okay. black coffee. Yeah.
Okay.
And black coffee, you know, it's only coffee, water and coffee. No sugar, no milk, no nothing. Right?
Okay.
No,
okay.
Extremos tampoco no llego. Pero a little sugar. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
How much milk do you drink? Do you drink milk?
I drink a lot of milk.
Okay.
Especially almond.
Okay, almond milk. That's good. That's good. Coconut milk, almond milk, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Do you like coffee with milk?
Yes, I like cappuccino, but only with on cream, with no cream, I don't remember. Descremado, I don't remember.
Let me see, because it's not on cream. I don't remember. Okay, no, I don't think it is on cream. Let me check.
Okay.
Skim? Skim, me aparece. Skim, me aparece como descremado o descremada.
Yes,
skim. Skim milk.
Skim milk.
Skim milk.
Skim milk. Yeah. A brand, right? That is skim milk. Yes. Semi skim or skim, right?
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that is talking about countable, uncountable nouns. So you can say how much chicken do you eat? So if we tend to eat a lot of chicken, right? The chicken, everyday chicken, 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 chicken. So how much chicken do you eat? How much rice do you eat? Or how much rice do you buy, right? How much rice do you have in your house? How much water do you drink, right? How much water? Yes, water, I thought. Okay, how much water do you drink? How much bread? As I am representing everything, how much bread do you eat, right? How many tortillas do you eat? How much cheese? I was having dinner. So how much cheese do you eat? Okay, so remember, cheese, bread, chicken are not countable, right? These are uncountable words, okay? Now, let's go with the countable. How many days are there in January? How many days are there in January? Do you remember?
January, there are 31.
There are 31.
Yes.
I remember my mom taught me something. So we said, January, like in the nudito, right? So you say January, February, March, April, May. Okay, January, February, May, June, July, August, September. So no sé cómo, but they were counting that cuando caí en el nudito era de 31 y cuando no era de 30. So something like that. Okay, that was a way people used to know when a month was of 30 or 31, right? Okay, so how many people work in your company? Somebody told me yesterday, 7. How many people work in your company? In my company?
In my company work, 65 people.
Okay, 65 people working my company. Great. Huh. What about the others? How many people?
Está calladito, don Walter. Tiene sueño. El frío, el frío.
Estoy tratando de entenderle.
How many? How many? Counting, counting.
In my company work and 40 persons.
40 people. Okay, 40 people. Yes. Okay, that's a good company.
Ya me picaste, Ángel.
Ya ve, pues. You wake up.
Okay, tell me, do you like to read? Do you like to read?
No.
Why? Okay, how many books do you read in a year? Don't tell me.
I read one book.
Zero. Oh, one. Okay, one. It should be big, right? To last all the year, it should be big. Okay?
I like read, but I cannot time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So.
Yeah, it's. We read on we read a lot of things.
Okay. Yes.
What about the others, Edwin? How many books do you read in a year? Les voy a lanzar un reto. Que lean un libro en inglés.
Es.
Aunque le dure 2 años.
Lo que dure el curso.
Yes. And by the end of the 15 courses, you tell me, teacher.
When do you recommend, teacher?
There are many books in English. One thing I look for in a book is that it has an easy language. And it has to be about something that you like. See? For example, for reading, I like adventure. I like romance and adventure and detective books. Those are my favorite, right? So it depends on what you like to read. Look for a book where which letters are big, right? Look for the letters that they are big, that the book is separated in small paragraphs. Because if you take a book that goes.
The kindergarten books.
Yeah, no. You can begin with those. Those are perfect. Okay, so imagine you get a book that a complete page, solo empieza a leer y se me va a asustar, ¿verdad? Se va a decepcionar. Entonces, no. Libros que lleven así, parrafitos chiquitos, 3-4 líneas, 5 líneas, lo mucho, párrafo pequeño. Entonces, veamos un libro así. Que vaya parrafito chiquito, letra grande. Y eso lo va a motivar. Right? And then you will tell me, yes, I read 10 books a year. It doesn't matter if it is small. You begin with something, right? Okay. How many students are there in class right now? Right now, how many students are there in class right now?
In the class right now, 50 students.
There are 15 students in the class?
There are 15 students in the class. Give me a second. Okay, how many students are there in the class right now? There are
16 students.
16 students. How many teachers are there in the class right now? How many?
There's only one.
There is one teacher. How many computers are connected right now? How many computers? How many computers are there connected? About 16?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so no problem, no questions about how much and how many? Yeah? Okay. Que me está doliendo la cabeza. Entonces, pues mejor. Ready. Okay. Check this daily routine. It's like something kind of relaxing, some activities to have fun, some others that are definitely necessary. Let's see. We are including the time in most of them. Okay, I wake up. Repeat. I wake up at 6 a.m.
I wake up at 6 a.m.
A.m.
At 6 a.m.
I wake up at 6 a.m.
I get up at 6:15.
I get up at 6:15.
I make my bed at 6:20.
I make my bed at 6:20.
I brush my teeth at 6:25.
I take a shower at 6:30.
I listen to music. Probably if you don't want to say it in the morning.
I listen to music in the morning.
I go to work at 7:15.
I go to work at 7:15.
I go home. Vamos a quitar un tú que está de más.
I go home at 4:30.
You go to work, go to the gym, go to the beach, go to home. I go to my friend's house. I go to my friend's house.
I go to my friend's house
after work. Yeah, I go to my friend's house after work. I go to my friend's house. My friend's house, my mother's house, my grandma's house, my aunt's house. La casa de todo el mundo, pero es la suya. Okay? You cannot say I go to my house. Say I go home. Okay? Usted dice, oh, you go home, but you go to somebody else's house. I go to my grandma's house. I go to my mom's house. I go to my brother's house. Pero, okay. Now, I go to the gym at 5. I go to the gym at 5. Okay. What time do you go to the gym? I go to the gym. I do my homework at 6. Repeat after me. I do the homework at 6.
I do my homework at 6.
I have dinner at 7.
I have dinner at 7.
I watch TV at 7.
I go to bed at 10:40.
What time do you go to bed?
I go to bed
at 11.
Okay. Now I'm going to show you a couple of pictures. I don't know if you have questions here. Questions. Any questions? No questions? No? No questions? No.
No questions.
No question, teacher.
I'm going to show you some pictures for you to identify the routine. Okay. Let's see. Okay. What about the first one?
I go to bed. The 10:10.
I go to bed at
8 o'clock.
I go to bed at
10:10.
I go to bed at 10:10. Okay. What else could that be? Mm-hmm. Apart of go to bed, that we get up. So you say I get up at 10:10 on the weekend. Do you get up at 10:10 on the weekend?
I get up.
I get up at 10:10.
Saturday.
On Saturday. Do you get up at 10:10 on Saturday? That would be nice. Yeah, I get up at 10. At 10:10 on the weekend. Vamos a ver. I want to show you something, right? Because you're describing routine, but you can also describe it in negative. Check. When we use the negative, this is a review because we were talking about this on Thursday, right? Okay, or Friday, something like that. Remember, we have the subject, the auxiliary do or does, depending on the situation, the negation, not, and then the verb in the base form and the complement. And you say, she does not work on weekends. Does not. She does not, or you can also use the contraction and say, she doesn't. She doesn't work on weekends. Yes? She doesn't work on weekends. They do not have much time. Or they do not have. They don't have enough time. Yes? You can perfectly use a contraction there, no problem. She does not work on weekends, but she doesn't work on weekends. They do not have much time or they don't have much time. Here we have some other examples. Maria does not work. Maria does not work at HPBC. She does not work or doesn't work. Maria doesn't work at HPBC. Marcos does not stay late at work. He doesn't stay late at work, doesn't. Juan and Pedro do not write reports. Juan and Pedro don't write reports, don't write reports. We do not send letters. We don't send letters. So you can perfectly use a contraction here, not a problem with the contraction, right? But remember, I'm going to write it here. We use with he, she, and it. I'm going to use don't or doesn't. Who tells me? What do I use with he, she, it? Don't or doesn't?
Doesn't.
So you say, Maria doesn't work. Marcos doesn't pay. But if you have two people, in that case, we're talking about they, right? Juan and Pedro, they. Juan and Pedro is they. Juan and I is we. Because I'm included, right? Juan and I. Maria and I. Okay? And then you have you. And I. In this case, with this pronouns, what is the auxiliary do you need? Who can tell?
Done.
I use done. Yeah. In that case, I say don't. So he doesn't, she doesn't, it doesn't, but they don't, we don't, you don't, and I don't. Okay, that's how we are going to be using the auxiliary. Now, going back to the routine, I want you to think about you, right? I want you to think about you and what you do. Do you get up at 6 a.m.? So you say, no, I don't get up at 6 a.m. I get up at 7 a.m. Or no, I don't get up at 6 a.m. I get up at 4. Right? Or I get up at 5 a.m. Yeah. Do you take a shower at 6:30?
I take a shower at 4 a.m.
Oui, very early. Okay. So you can
yes.
I don't take a shower at 6:30. I take a shower at 4. Okay. Do you have breakfast at 7? Okay. What about you? Do you have do you have breakfast at 7? Hmm?
Yes, I have a breakfast at 6.
You have 7. You have breakfast at 7. Okay. What about the others? Yuri, what time do you have breakfast? Do you have breakfast at 7, Yuri?
I 7 breakfast.
Okay, I have breakfast. I have breakfast at 7.
7.
Okay. Let's see, Kenya. Do you go to work at 7:15? Microphone. The microphone. Do you go to work at 7:15?
No, I don't go to work at 15. I go to work at 6:15.
Okay, at 6:15. Okay, very good. Teresa, do you go to your friend's house after work? Do you go to your friend's house after work?
No.
No, I don't go to my friend's house.
My friend's house. Mm-hmm. After work.
Okay, no, I don't go to my friend's house after work. I go home after work, right?
Okay.
Okay, now you tell me alone. No.
No.
Mm-hmm.
No. I go to.
No.
No, I don't.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't go to my friend's house after work.
Yes.
Okay.
I go home. Mm-hmm. Excellent, yes.
Okay.
Excellent. Let's
Ay, teacher, ¿qué cuesta esto?
Así se aprecia lo que cuesta. Lo que okay. No cuesta, pues nada, ni me costó.
Eso sí.
Pero si me cuesta, se valora y se queda más.
Eso sí.
Que uno le pone un poquito más de empeño porque le cuesta. Así es que don't worry. A mí también me costó, no crea usted que bien galán llegué, entré y salí hablando inglés. Me costó un buen rato. Ok, let's see. Acá, por acá. Maura, do you go to the gym at 5 p.m.? Do you go to the gym at 5 p.m.?
I go to the gym at 6 p.m.
At 6 p.m.?
Yes. Okay.
So first you tell me negative, right? No.
I don't go to the gym at 5 p.m.
I go to the gym.
I don't know.
First a negative, right? And then the affirmative. I'm going to show you. Let me do something. Okay, let's move here. Okay, you're here, right? So you tell me, no, I don't go to the gym at 5. I go to the gym, first a negative. I don't go to the gym. At 5. I go to the gym. At 6. Yeah, like that. So you first tell me the negative one. Let's put first in negative. No, I don't go to the gym at 5. I go to the gym at 6. Yes? Okay, no, I don't go to the gym at 5. I go to the gym at 6. Vamos a ver. Yuri, do you go to work at 7 p.m.? At 7 a.m.? Sorry. Do you go to work at 7 a.m.? Or at 7:15? Do you go to work at 7:15? Yuri.
Thank you, Cher.
Do you go to the gym at
7:15? I don't go to the gym at 6 p.m.
Oh, sorry, do you go to work or do you go to the gym? Do you go to work at 7:15?
Yes, I don't go to home work.
I don't go to work at 7:15. So you tell me time, right? No.
No.
I go to work at 7:15. I go to work
at 6 p.m.
Bueno, es que mi horario es al revés. Yo empiezo a trabajar tarde. I start work at 9 and I finish at 10 p.m., right? But in the morning, I start very late at 9. I start at 9 in the morning. Okay, let's see. Tell me. Por aquí, los que no me ahorita. Marlene, do you do the homework at 6? Do you do the homework at 6? Yes. No.
Do you, yes.
Do you do the homework at 6? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, yes, I do the homework at 6. I get my complete answer, right? Yes. 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 I say it.
Well, yes.
I
my home.
I do my homework. Homework.
I do my homework in the 6.
At 6. Yes, I do my homework at 6. Okay. A ver, Aristides, do you go to a friend's house after work? Microphone. Microphone, microphone, microphone.
Sorry. Okay. No, I don't go to my friend's house after work because I have English class.
Okay. I don't go to after class because English class. Okay, perfect. So you say, I don't go.
After work, teacher.
I don't
go. After work.
Yo que puse. Ajá.
After class.
Bueno, como para nosotros los teachers, este.
The work is a class.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't go to my friend's house after work because I have an English class. Okay, perfect. And the last one, a ver, Walter. Do you go to bed at 10 p.m.? Do you go to bed?
I don't go to bed at 10:40 a.m. I go to bed at 11 p.m.
Okay. At 10:40. 11 p.m. Okay, nice. Who goes to bed at 10? Somebody goes to bed at 10. Nobody. Who goes to bed at 11? No, at 10:30. At 11, Walter. Who goes to bed at 12? At 12. Who goes to bed at 12?
Some days.
Some days on the weekend, right? On the weekend.
Two days on the weekend.
Mm-hmm. On the weekend, we tend to go to bed later, right? Okay. Questions here. Questions. No questions. A ver, vamos a, déjeme que los ando moviendo para todos lados. Va, aquí está. Okay, do you have any questions? Yes, no. A ver, tell
no questions.
Does Walter go to bed at 10:40?
No.
No, okay. No.
No, he doesn't go to bed.
No, he doesn't go to bed at 10:40. Okay. No, he doesn't go to bed at 10:40. He
He does go to bed at 11 p.m.
He goes to bed.
He doesn't to bed at 11 p.m.
So we say he doesn't go to work at 10:40. He doesn't go to bed at 10:40. He goes to work at
11. He goes to bed, teacher. He goes to bed at 11 p.m.
Porque estamos pensando en work, dice hora de dormir, ¿verdad? Estamos locos. Ok, goes to bed at 11 p.m. Culpable, las dos aceptan mi nombre. Vamos a ver, he goes to bed. So, he doesn't go to bed at 10:40. He goes to bed at 11. And pay attention to the changes, right? Because we have changes there. Okay. Instead of saying don't, I use doesn't, porque estoy usando he. And instead of go, I use go. So he goes to bed, right? Yes. A ver, questions. I want to call attendance and then we will continue with the other sentences, right? A ver, Ángel.
Present.
Okay. Aristides.
Present.
Denia Guadalupe.
Present.
Eduardo Ernesto. Eduardo. No here. Okay. Edwin Orlando.
Present.
Fátima.
Present, teacher.
Isabel.
Present.
Luis Mauricio. Mauricio. I'm here, Luis Mauricio, today. María Fermelinda.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Marisela. Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Aura.
Present.
Okay. Miriam.
Present.
Oscar Alejandro. Oscar. Ricardo. Teresa.
Present, teacher.
Walter.
Present, teacher.
Yesenia. Se ver a Yesenia por ahí.
Sí estaba.
¿Verdad que sí?
Pero se desconectó hace un ratitito.
Sí, me pareció ver. Y Oscar también. Okay. Bueno, let's continue. Right.
Let's go. Yo t-shirt.
Okay, okay. Pasha. Do you have questions here?
No.
No.
Teacher, a mí no me mencionó.
¿A quién no mencioné? Amanda.
Teacher, quizás me mencionó, pero me quedé sin internet. No sé si me habrá mencionado porque me sacó de la clase.
Vamos a ver, Yesenia.
Hasta ahorita acabo de lograr entrar, sí.
Va, ahí está.
No sé si ya pasó lista.
Sí, ahorita le pongo present. Y Maura.
Gracias, le agradezco. Okay.
No, a Yuri.
A mí no me mencionó,
Yuri, a quién no. A Yuri, Yuri, no la llamé.
Estoy presente, teacher.
Ok, sorry, Yuri. Sorry. Ok, ahí le pongo presente. Thank you. Ok, vaya. Now, I'm going to share some pictures with you. And we are going to make affirmative and negative sentences. Right? Let's see later. Me hace mal acetaminofén, ¿verdad? Qué barbaridad. Vaya, no question here. So let's go to the pictures. A ver, so you can tell me, well, I don't get up at 10. I get up at 4, right? I don't wear makeup. Do you wear makeup? And the boys will say, like, no.
Right? Oh.
No.
No.
That's easy for you to write your negative sentence, right? So you say, I don't wear makeup. Okay. Well, I don't wear mascara. No mascara para pestañas, right? No mascara. That's mascara. Do you wear a mascara? Hmm? Only mascarilla. Right? Do you wear a mascara? Girls? Girls, girls? Do you wear a mascara? No? Okay, then you can say, I don't wear a mascara. A ver. Remember, what you're going to do is to write negative sentences here. And then you tell me, let's make it white. I don't, or she doesn't, see? You can say, she gets up. She gets up at 10:10. She doesn't get up at 7. She gets up at 10:10. No importa si primero pone la affirmative, después la negative, o primero la negative, después la affirmative, no problem. Ok. She gets up at 10:10. She doesn't get up at 7 a.m. What about this one? puede compararse su rutina con la persona también. Puede decir, she wears a mascara, I don't wear a mascara. Right. Okay. Write the sentence. Write the sentence over there. She wears a mascara, but I don't wear a mascara, right?
We're gonna say the sentence.
write the sentences and tell me, right?
Okay.
¿Qué ponemos?
She gets a mascara.
Okay, she wears a mascara.
She wears eyelash masks.
She wears a mascara. What about you? Do you wear a mascara? Okay. No. She wears a mascara. Do you wear a mascara?
I don't.
She wears a mascara. I don't. I don't wear a mascara. She wears a mascara. I don't wear a mascara.
Can I say a sentence?
Sure.
She likes to wear a mascara, but Teresa doesn't like.
Okay.
Doesn't like it.
Yes, perfect, perfect. Now, let's go to the next picture. You take a shower, right? Oh, of course, I take a shower. Uh-huh. So, what can you tell me? I don't take a shower. At night. Do you ever take a shower at night?
Sometimes.
Yes, I take a shower at night.
Take a shower at night. Okay. After getting from the street, right? Okay. So tell me a sentence here for this picture. For the first picture. Oi, wash your hands is part of our, right? That should definitely be part of our routine. Wash your hands. Using how many? How many times do you wash your hands in a day?
She washes it how many times a day?
Okay, the sentence you can say, she washes her hands many times during the day. What about you?
I wash, o sea, ¿cómo es? I wash her hands.
I wash my hands.
Wash my hands.
A lot of times. See?
A lot of times.
Yeah, I wash my hands like, I don't know many times, but a lot. Yeah. Okay. What about this picture? The second picture. Tell me a sentence. Affirmative or negative?
Podría ser, como se dice, ella no lava sus manos con jabón.
She doesn't wash her hands with soap. She doesn't.
She does not, ¿verdad? Wash her hands with soap.
Wash her hands.
Teacher, permiso para salirme, por favor.
¿Perdón?
Permiso para salirme, por favor.
Yesenia.
Sí, por favor.
Vamos a ver que ya no se va a ver todas las letras. has to be. She washes her hands with many times during the day, but she doesn't wash her hands with soap. Okay. Now, what about this one?
She takes a shower before go to work.
Okay. She takes a shower before she goes to work. Okay. Or you can say before. Before going to work, right? Okay. Me gusta más. She takes a shower before going to work. Or before work. Okay. Now, I'm going to send you to the rooms y les voy a poner dos fotos más para que en el room ustedes, aparte de completar, ya les voy a enseñar que van a escribir oraciones para estas pictures. Check. These two pictures.
Siempre negativo.
Puede ser negativo. Affirmative or negative. Affirmative or negative. And here you will definitely. You will definitely use don't or doesn't to complete the sentences. Vamos a ver. I'm going to share this with you here. Vamos a chat. I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to send the sentences. Well, yeah, the sentences and the picture to the chat. Okay, maybe que mi teléfono dice que está descargado. Vamos a ver si se va. Ay, check. Sí, ¿verdad? Vaya, I'm going to share the pictures too. Se la voy a poner en una sola slide para que no tengan tanta cosa. Vamos a ponerles tantas pictures. Va, recuerden, probablemente ustedes sí hacen las cosas, pero no a esa hora. ¿Ok? O las hacen diferente. So that's what you're going to write here. A ver, ahorita les ubico para que se vayan completas todas las fechas. A Shaban. Va, ready? Yes. Yes, yes. Checking in el WhatsApp. I already sent the pictures. Now I'm going to. I will have one group of three, well, one group of four, and all the others are groups of three. ¿Qué vamos a hacer allá? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? First, complete the sentences usando don't o doesn't. Y después me van a escribir dos oraciones sobre ustedes. Para ellos se van a basar en las pictures que les acabo de mandar. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Perfecto, ya vamos.
Lo de completar las oraciones ya no.
¿Cómo no? Completan las oraciones y después, si se fijan, ahí al final dice escribir después de las oraciones, write two more things that you don't do. Entonces, para eso se van a basar en las pictures. Ahí les mando pictures, porque a veces dicen, pero es que no se me ocurre nada. Entonces ahí tiene pictures, por ejemplo, si me quiere decir, I don't walk with the dog because I don't have a dog. I don't go to the park. I don't sit down in the park. I don't walk alone. So, cualquier cosa me puede decir. Ahí tiene las pictures así como para que se ilumine y me escribe las oraciones extras. Allá vamos. Ready? Yes?
Ready.
Perfect. There you go. Vamos a ver, Maura, María y Benia, chequen a ver si se logran unir al grupo. Right.
Don, ¿verdad? We don't.
We don't.
We don't go to the cinema too much.
We don't. We don't,
We don't go to the cinema too much.
Sí, sería doesn't, ¿verdad? She doesn't.
She doesn't. Play soccer at night.
Ajá. They sería don't, ¿verdad?
They don't.
Don't, correcto. Mm-hmm.
Don sería doesn't, ¿verdad?
She doesn't.
She doesn't.
She doesn't.
She doesn't go to work.
Doesn't.
Ajá. John sería. Doesn't. Doesn't. Sí, doesn't. John sería doesn't, ¿verdad?
Doesn't, yes.
Y the pet, que es la mascota, sería...
Doesn't.
Doesn't, ¿verdad?
Doesn't run in the park.
Doesn't, ¿verdad?
Doesn't.
Doesn't.
Ajá. Vale. Ya tenemos esas, supuestamente. Ahora vamos con las imágenes, ¿verdad? Ok, tiene que ser, dijo que affirmative o negative, ¿verdad?
Exacto.
Vamos con la primera entonces.
Dijo que las podíamos hacer relacionadas.
¿Con qué las podíamos hacer? ¿Con nosotros?
Sí.
Sí.
También.
Con algo que usted no haga de las imágenes. Si usted no va al parque, pues no va al parque.
Yo no voy al parque. Entonces sería I don't. I don't.
I don't.
I don't go to the park.
I don't go to the park.
I don't go to the park. I don't go to the park. Otra sería tampoco se, esa va a ser individual, cada quien la va a hacer dependiendo, o en grupo,
sí, cada quien haga su oración y le dice a los compañeritos.
Ah, ok. Uh-huh. Bueno.
Porque ahí va a variar lo de cada quien, qué es lo que no hace, right?
Ah, bueno.
Y dice que vamos a escribir otras dos cosas que no hagamos.
I don't go to the gym.
Yo le escribí, Ángel doesn't go to the gym.
Mm-hmm. I don't have a pet. No sé si...
Tu micrófono, Nidia.
Ahorita ahí la apago porque mucho peso. En la cuarta sería dance.
Sería doesn't run. Estamos hablando de la mascota. ¿Verdad, teacher?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Pero.
The pet doesn't.
Yeah,
the room in the park. Okay, entonces si nos vamos a las pictures, empecemos a escribir un par de frases por cada picture.
Okay. Ahorita.
No se preocupe, Nidia, no se preocupe, está bien.
La verdad que tengo una tos como alérgica, que ya tengo varios días de estar así.
Y no se había conectado, ¿verdad?
Fíjese que no había podido porque mi mamá y yo hemos estado súper mal de la garganta. Pero
bueno, aquí bueno. Está. Vaya, bien. Gracias por el esfuerzo.
Sí.
Vaya, la primera pudiera ser, pudiéramos escribir una affirmative y una negative, ¿les parece?
Me parece bien una negative y una positive.
Ajá, entonces, pudiera ser, I go to the park. In the afternoon o at night, ¿les parece una muy buena frase?
I go in the afternoon.
I go to the park in the afternoon or at night. Escríbanla antes que se me vaya porque se me está ahumando el cerebro.
Go to the park.
Go. Estoy poniendo a prueba mi maní, teacher.
Yay, eso. No, the maní is very good for the memory. You can eat peanut. Eat peanut.
Mi esposa me friega, dice que yo tengo un maní de cerebro.
Bueno, hay que demostrar que no es cierto.
Ok, y la negativa del park pudiera hacer. She doesn't go to the park weekend or in.
In the.
During the day.
Teacher, okay. I have a question. Can I say during the day or all day long?
It depends. It depends. What do you exactly want to say?
About when the sun is shining?
You say the sun shines all day long.
Okay. No, but I get when I say I don't watch TV during the day.
That's okay. So you by imagine if you tell me I watch TV during the day, but at night I don't watch TV. Oh, I watch TV the whole day. So that means that you wake up.
All day.
Go to the sofa to watch TV, and then you wake up from the sofa to go to bed. So that was all day long. Yeah. But if you say I watch TV during the day, no necesariamente va a ser todo el tiempo que va a estar viendo tele. Right?
Okay.
So, but it could be maybe 1 hour, 2 hours, or it doesn't matter. Pero si usted dice, I watch TV all day long, desde que se levanta hasta que va a dormir.
Hasta que se acuesta.
Okay. Okay.
Includes all
Thanks.
Day.
Okay. Okay, one more. Don Edwin.
One more. I don't play soccer during the day.
Read is report. No.
Sí. No. Huh?
Doesn't report.
No. Huh? No review report.
It's report.
Si no, escribiendo nota, ¿verdad? If
he the report write note.
Sería he doesn't review report but reading the note, no sé.
He doesn't make notes. Cuando usted apunta, cuando yes. usted no apunta o toma nota de algo, por ejemplo,
mm-hmm.
then you say make notes. He doesn't make notes or he makes notes. Toma nota.
Make notes. Ah, okay. Creo que sí sería. Estás en review report, but make note. Make. Uh-huh.
Hoy solo nos faltarían las dos oraciones de nosotras, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Yes.
Ok. Okay, I'm going to call you in a minute. Vamos a ver. Okay, I want to take you to the manual now. Let me show you the manual. Well, on your manual, you will go to page number 18, right? Page 18 in your manual. What you remember, I told you, make two sentences about you. ¿Sí? ¿Quiénes hicieron sus oraciones? Yes, okay. Did you share them with your partners? Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. But right now, I'm going to send you in pairs. We're going to be moving. I'm going to be changing your partner a lot. So what you're going to do here is that as you already had, right? Ya tiene las oraciones sobre usted. Hoy la va a compartir con sus compañeros. So we have, check here, write 6 negative sentences about you and a colleague. ¿Se acuerdan? Bueno, los voy a tomar. Los voy a llevar de regreso. Check. Aquí les compartí porque ya no sé. Vamos a ver. Ya no sé si les compartí el manual o si les compartí la presentación. Va, ok. I'm taking you to the presentation right now. Check. Remember, in these sentences, I told you, she takes a shower before going to work.
that I take a shower after the work. She gets up at 10. She doesn't get up at 7. She wears a mascara, but I don't wear a mascara. And here you can tell me, she gets up at 10:10, but I get up at 6 o'clock, right? Entonces vamos a ir comparando lo que su compañero hace y lo que usted. ¿Ok? Entonces, en esta parte, vamos a ver. So you say, let me get a... a ver. So you say, I get up. Oh, I don't, porque six negative sentences about you and about a colleague, right? I don't go to the park on the weekend. But Walter goes to the park on Saturday. ¿Sí? Entonces, me va a ir diciendo, ya sea negativa la suya o negativa la de su compañero, ¿verdad? O pueden ser negativas las dos. Por ejemplo, si dice, María and I, sorry María, pero yo ocupo mucho María, Pedro, ¿se acuerdan? Ok, then you say, María, quizás porque mi mami se llamaba María. María and I don't go to the park on the weekend. We go to the park in the morning. Or we never go to the park, right? María and I don't go to the park. Como me va a escribir six negative sentences about you and another person. Entonces, tiene dos opciones. Tiene dos opciones porque no siempre va a ser negativo para los dos. En algún momento puede ser afirmativo para uno, negativo para el otro o negativo para los dos. ¿Ok? Is that clear for you?
Yes.
Yes. Perfect. Vaya, I'm going to send you to the small groups, but in pairs. De repente se va a quedar solito mientras llegue el otro, porque ahí le voy a ir quitando al compañero y mandándole a uno nuevo, para que al final logre completar las 6 oraciones. ¿Ok? Allá. Allá vamos. Hoy, now you go in pairs, right? Uy, Fátima, ¿por qué me queda solita? Bueno, ya le voy a mandar a Carlos. Ah, está. Qué chistoso. Me quedaba uno de 3 y uno de 1. Bye, ahí está. Ready? Ready, ready, ready. Tell your partner one sentence and then you compare you with your partner and write your sentence there. Allá vamos. María, cheque si se logra unir. Ahí está, perfecto.
Vamos a ver. Ahí está.
Maura, Maura and I don't go to the park on Sundays. Sí. On Sundays, en plural lo podemos poner.
You can put it on in plural, no problem.
Okay.
That means that Sunday. It happens, something that happens every Sunday, right?
Okay.
So yeah,
okay.
You can put it in plural.
Okay. Okay, Maura. Ya tenemos la primera. Okay. Ella me compartió una esta oración. Y hicimos una, ¿verdad? Ahora yo le tendría que compartir la mía para tener dos.
Exacto.
Ok. Entonces la mía era... I don't watch TV during the day.
Si quiere, inicie usted con su positiva.
Yes, I go to the golf in the field.
En mi caso sería, I go to the home at 5 p.m.
Entonces, escribiría, escribir entonces, I go to the golf. In the field, in the field. Yo estoy diciendo aquí que yo camino en el campo. Entonces usted dice que usted camina hacia el trabajo, ¿verdad?
Ah, yo voy hacia el trabajo. No,
yo voy a la casa, sería. Home. Ah, hacia la casa. Ah, ok. Entonces sería.
Entonces pongo Ángel.
Ajá.
Ángel, vuelvo a repetir.
I don't have a pet. Entonces, this is my
word. Ángel doesn't have a pet.
Ángel doesn't have.
What about you, Teresa? Pet. Do you have a pet?
Este, no, no saco a.
No,
a
pero pasear a mi tiene perro. Uno. ¿Cómo? Tiene un pet.
Ah, three.
Ah, okay.
Pero son chiquitos. Ángel doesn't have the pet, ¿verdad?
A pet.
But,
o sea, yo, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
I have three dogs.
Está más fácil que la primera oración que me había dicho.
Uh-huh.
I have three dogs. Uh-huh. You can say I have three dogs. Three. And Angel okay. Don't have a pet.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but Angel hey. Don't have a pet. Yes, you can do it, Teresa. Hey. No sea chica. No, aquí
qué
estamos
terrible,
aprendiendo.
Silenciada.
No.
Hoy sí siento que me está costando bastante esto.
¿Qué es?
Le digo a Ángel que ya me han ganado de salir corriendo, le digo.
No, si es lo mismo que
No se desanime.
Es lo mismo esto, ya lo vimos. Sin ninguno.
Sí, fíjense que se estaba viendo, ¿verdad? Aquí vimos el does y el doesn't, el do y el don't.
En el uno.
Solo lo estamos reforzando, Teresa, no sea chica.
Sí, sí, sí.
Ahí estamos.
Ya. Dele.
Ya le damos.
Cuesta.
Of course.
Sí, así me dicen.
Sí.
¿Cómo no va? Did you finish? No.
Tenemos yes. Dos.
Dos ya cada uno.
Ah, pues ya le voy a mandar a otro compañero.
Gracias, Anjo.
Ok.
Sí.
Hombre, Teresa, démosle.
Démosle, ¿verdad? Sí. Aunque me quede ahí. ¿Qué está diciendo Lali?
Fíjense que... A todos nos pasa que nos quedamos así como directo Pero como que a los días uno lo asimila. Y uno dice, hoy ya no me costó.
Llegó Ángel.
Bueno.
Vamos a ver de acá, ¿quién me llevo? Ah, no, me llevé a Teresa.
Ah, bueno, sí, va a Teresa.
Yes.
Ok.
Vamos a mover a Fátima. ¿Quién me llevo a Fátima? ¿Quién me llevo a...? Ahí está, vemos para el 1.
Ok. Thank you, teacher.
No, no sé. Sí, mandé. Ay, ok. Ay, ¿por qué me quedó solo uno? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Alguien se me fugó?
Sí.
Hola.
Yo estaba en otra sala y me pasó para acá.
Sí, yo les dije que los iba a estar moviendo.
Que nos va a estar cambiando, dijo la teacher.
Porque van a andar por todos lados. Sí, ahí me quedo solito y saben que se me escapó alguien. Vamos a ver. A ver quién se me salió.
Mándelo para acá, Isabel. Y redactamos. Vamos aquí.
Mandar para acá, fíjense, ¿por qué está solo? This is number.
I don't know. I don't remember.
Ah, number 3. Sí.
Okay. Denia.
Hello.
I don't take a shower. A shower. At 5 o'clock.
Entonces yo lo describiría como he doesn't.
O mejor Aristides. Aristides doesn't.
Aristides doesn't.
Takes a shower. No, doesn't take a shower.
Doesn't take a shower.
A shower at 5 o'clock.
At 5 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Ahí sí. Sí, porque es muy temprano.
Definitivamente no.
Yes, primarily. I agree with you.
Ok. Vaya, ahora yo puedo compartir la mía. Porque tenía dos.
Uh-huh.
La que no he compartido es I don't like watch.
Sí. ¿Verdad? Quise escribir de que yo no acostumbro a realizar cuentas mensualmente. Por eso le I don't monthly. Use. Ajá. To make okay. accounts monthly. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I am not used. Right? I am used to.
¿Cómo se permita? Y si yo quise decir, I am.
Sí. I am not used to.
I am. Don't use.
I am not used to.
Y si, o sea, que no se le pone el don.
Puede decir, I am not. Significa no estoy acostumbrado.
Entonces,
I am not used to
make accounts monthly.
No estoy acostumbrado. I am not used to. O si no se complique la vida y diga, I don't.
Por eso había puesto, I don't use. No, o no, I don't to make accounts monthly.
I don't make.
I don't make. Okay. O puedo decir I am not used to make. O puedo decir I don't make accounts monthly.
I don't make. ¿Qué es lo que no hace?
Cuentas mensualmente. O sea, como no sé. Cuentas en el aspecto de gastos, decía yo.
Ok. Entonces puede decir I don't keep the track of money. O sea, no llevo el control del dinero. I don't keep.
I don't keep
the track of money.
The track of money. Money. Uh-huh. Money.
Don't keep track of money.
I don't keep the track of money. Ah, bueno. Y si yo le digo eso a Walter, Walter me tendría que decir una oración de las que él hizo.
Pero,
I do. Entonces usted puede decir, I don't keep the track of money, but Walter keeps the track of money. O no, sí, ¿verdad?
Ah, o sea que lo que yo entendí, teacher, era que, por ejemplo, yo trabajé con Yuri. Yuri dijo, I don't go to the gym. Esa fue la frase que ella me dio.
Sí.
Pero yo hice que ella me dijera la affirmative. Entonces, él me dijo,
do you go to the gym?
I not to the gym.
Vaya, entonces, en ese caso, usted puede decir, Yuri and I don't go to the gym. Porque los dos no lo hacen. ¿Sí? Yuri and I don't go to the gym. Pero en el caso de Teresa, ella no lleva control del dinero, pero usted sí.
Entonces, ella, ¿cómo trasladaría yo la oración? Pudiera ser she
doesn't. Dale Teresa para que se acuerde de quién fue el que le dio esa oración. Teresa doesn't keep track of money. Teresa doesn't keep track of money, but I keep track of money at work. Porque usted colecta dinero y lleva control y todo eso, ¿verdad? ¿O no?
Sí, sí, sí. Ajá, entonces,
Teresa doesn't keep track of money, but I keep track of money. Ella no, pero yo sí.
Entonces yo tendría que poner, yo puse I don't keep the track of money, but Walter.
Ahí puede decir Walter keeps track of money, but I don't keep track of money.
Uh-huh.
Porque él sí, pero usted no.
Entonces Walter
keeps track of money.
Keeps track money.
Track of money, but I don't keep track of money.
Ah, confuso.
Ahorita ya quedé más perdido que la china.
Yo también. Ya no se preocupe que no es el único, Walter. Yo ando
ya le puedes. Vaya, se acuerda.
Ando dando día peor que los gestores de tráfico.
Okay. Ando dando día peor que el noticiero y el que da lo del clima.
Vaya, chequen.
El clima.
Ay, Nidia, se me escapó. Vaya, chequen esto. Pueden haber dos situaciones, porque no siempre va a decir que a los dos no le gusta o que los dos no hacen algo, ¿sí? Por ejemplo, en este caso, Walter sí hace algo, pero Teresa no. Entonces, en este caso, vamos a usar este formato, mire. I don't go to the park on the weekend, but Walter goes to the park on the weekend. Él sí va al parque, yo no.
Uh-huh.
¿Ya? Entonces, ese es el modelo que ustedes van a usar en esa oración que están haciendo ahorita. Si los dos no hicieran lo que están diciendo, podrían decir.
This is Teresa and I.
Teresa and I don't keep track of money. Porque ninguno de los dos lo hace.
Ok.
Pero en este caso, que Teresa no lleva el control de dinero, pero Walter sí.
Ok.
¿Sí? Entonces puede decir Teresa, I don't keep track of money, but Walter keeps, con S, keeps track of money.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Y Walter diría, dice Walter, I keep track of money, but Teresa doesn't keep track of money.
Doesn't keep control.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Okay. Okay. Entonces, pudiera la frase, ¿cómo es? Recapitulando un poco. Entonces, yo le voy a decir a Teresa, Teresa, yo, I, pudiera ser, I walk to the pet in the morning.
Ok, y Teresa, porque yo,
I don't walk the pet. Uh-huh. Puede ser que no tenga mascota ella.
Tiene tres.
Tengo tres.
Entonces, pudiera ser Teresa and I
walk the pet in the park.
Walk in the pet in the park in the morning. Uh-huh. Okay. Se me volvió a ahumar el cerebro, teacher.
Nos está saliendo humo, teacher. Y dolor de cabeza.
Nah.
Huele a quemado, teacher.
Sí, qué barbaridad. Cerebro.
Vaya, entonces, hoy sí ya le logré entender, Teresa. Entonces, busquemos una actividad que hagamos, no sé, tal vez que usted envíe correos, por ejemplo.
Sí, ajá. Sería...
Entonces, Teresa...
How are you doing? ¿Cómo vamos?
Bien. Escribiendo lo que puedo escribir.
Perfecto. Vaya, share with your partner what you have. ¿Qué tienen? Vamos a ver.
Uy, el primer compañero me dijo, Isabel me dijo, he don't go to the gym in the morning.
He doesn't go to the gym. Uh-huh. Bueno, me los voy a llevar ya, fíjense. Okay, Maura. Hello, Maura.
Hello, teacher.
Vaya, vamos a ver what you have. Okay. Okay, I would like to listen to a couple of volunteers. Some volunteers. Marlene me estaba leyendo.
Ay, teacher.
Me dijeron la primera. He doesn't go to the gym in the morning.
Okay.
He doesn't. He doesn't work to go to the lot attack in the pool, in the bus, perdón.
Okay.
La compañera me dijo, she doesn't go to the gym. She doesn't report every day.
Okay, great. Thank you, Marlene. Vamos a leer. Let's listen to Isabel. Tell me, Isabel.
Okay. Bye. I don't go to the gym in the morning, but Marlene doesn't check email. Y la segunda sería, I don't walk a lot for take the bus. Y Marlene, she does write report every day.
She doesn't write reports every day. Yeah?
No. Yes. Yeah. Y es y bueno, otra mía sería I don't sit in a bench but Dania she doesn't go to the class in the morning.
Okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Vaya, vamos a la attendance. This is the last attendance of the day. Vamos a ver. Tell me, Ángel Antonio.
Present.
Great. Aristides.
Present.
Denia.
Present.
Okay, Eduardo. Eduardo. No, verdad. Edwin.
Present.
Great. Fátima Xiomara.
Present, teacher.
Isabel.
Present.
Luis Mauricio. María Martínez. María. Okay. Marisela. Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Maura.
Present.
Nice. Nidia. Nidia, Nidia, Nidia. Oscar. Ricardo. Teresa.
Present, teacher.
Walter.
Present, teacher.
Yesenia. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Bueno, that's all for today. Great. Thank you for being here. And stay in the whole class, right? See you tomorrow. Hoy le tocaba quedarse a Eduardo, no Eduardo. Bueno, see you tomorrow. Have a nice day.
See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night.
Good night.
See you tomorrow. God
good
bless
night,
you,
everybody.
Bless you.
Nos salvamos, Ángel.
Tomorrow. Hi, Mari. Hi. Hi, Mari. Hello. Mari, hello. La veo por allí. No sé si está por allí.
Sí, por acá. Estoy desconectado porque desconecté el inter.
Ah, ok.
Y sigue activo, creo que está con los datos del teléfono.
Sí. Qué tremendo.
Bueno,
bueno, see you tomorrow. Bye bye.
See you tomorrow.
Hi, Nidia. Hello, Nidia. How are you? Hi. Do you have any question?
Perdón, teacher, pero tenía problemas aquí. Me ha dado problemas esto. Creo que ni la atendale. Pero aquí
la vi que estaba por allí.
Sí, teacher, pero tenía problemas con el internet y no me podía salir.
Qué tremendo. Sí, y la vi que me la sacaba de los grupos pequeños, ¿verdad?
Sí, tuve problemas, no estuve en los últimos grupos.
Sí, vaya, y lo que estuvimos haciendo en los últimos grupos fue las oraciones negativas con el compañero, ¿verdad? Poniendo, por ejemplo, I, oh, María and I don't walk the dog. Uh-huh. O I walk the dog, but María doesn't walk the dog. Entonces, podría ser cualquiera de las dos, ¿verdad? Ya fuera que sea negativa para los dos, que ninguno de los dos hace las cosas, o que sea afirmativo para uno y negativo para el otro, ¿verdad? Entonces puede decir, por ejemplo, I clean the table, but Walter doesn't clean the table. Yes. O I wash the dishes, but Luis doesn't wash the dishes. O Luis washes the dishes, but I don't wash the dishes. Entonces podría ser así. Afirmativa para usted, negativa para él, o lo contrario, ¿verdad? O negativa para los dos.
Negativa. Uh-huh.
Por ejemplo, I don't, well, Teresa and I don't go to the movies, por ejemplo. Es para las dos. Teresa and I don't go to the movies. María and I don't walk the dog. María and I don't walk alone. Sí, podría ser. O sea,
negativos y positivos, ¿verdad?
Sí.
I go y I no.
I don't go. Por ejemplo, acá, que le puse una. Vamos a ver si. Aquí estoy en la pérdida. Vamos a poner en modo presente. Tenemos, I don't go to the park, but Walter goes to the park. ¿Verdad? Entonces podemos decir lo que yo no hago, pero el otro sí. María and I don't go to the park. O sea, ninguno de los dos va al parque el fin de semana. María and I don't go to the park on the weekend. We go to the park in the morning. ¿Ya? María and I don't, porque estamos usando the two. We go to the park in the morning. O puede perfectamente decir Luis and I. Watch TV. Watch TV after class. En ese caso, las dos personas hacen lo mismo. Uh-huh. After class. Yeah. Luis and I watch TV after class. O Luis watches TV after class. Te ha pegado mal la gripe.
Sí, se me ha quedado la tos y ya tengo varios días de estar así, no se me quita.
¿Y qué ha estado tomando?
Fíjese que es como alérgica, entonces hasta he estado tomando esteroides, pero ni eso me está funcionando.
Y se acuerda que se andaba yo el curso pasado, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
A mí lo que me dio mi hermana me puso a tomar vitaminas.
Uh-huh.
Me mandó a tomar un complejo, me dijo, toma vitaminas. Yo las que tenía eran cereales, que llevan B1, B6, B12 y un poquito de zinc y de todo. Entonces, una de esas en la mañana, una en la noche. Una vitamina C en la mañana, una en la noche y equinacia. equinacia, una en la mañana, una en la noche. Yo las compré en las farmacias San Nicolás. Ahí no son, el botecito trae, no, cajita es. Trae
tres. En las farmacias San Roque.
La San Roque. Entonces no me queda ni una cerca, es más barata, yo sé. Entonces, con vitaminas fue que a mí se me, de repente me agarra, porque igual me da alergia. Pero con eso me bajó bastante, pruebe. ¿Verdad? A veces lo que le hace falta al cuerpo es un poquito más de vitaminas.
Vitaminas, así.
Para que así, en vez de tomar más pastillas, pues, que al final le afectan a uno, mejor fortalecer las defensas con vitaminas. Las defensas.
Así es, sí, eso me ha faltado, porque me he tratado más como por la alergia, la gripe, pero vitaminas sí. Sí,
no. Pero la equinacia le ayuda para la alergia, porque yo así estaba, yo iba a tomar antihistamínico y me dijo ella no, porque el antihistamínico lo que hace es secarte más la garganta y producirte más tos. Es mejor tomar equinacia y eso te va a ayudar. Y sí, la verdad me ha ayudado un montón. ¿Puede?
Gracias, Chicho.
Dios quiera que con la vitamina le fortalezca los bronquios y la equinacia le va a ayudar para las alergias.
Así es. Gracias.
Y a tomar mucho tecito.
Sí, eso sí, estaba tomando bastante.
El tecito ayudó un montón.
Por ejemplo, si voy a contestar afirmativo y me preguntan a mí, puedo contestar yes, I go the park in the morning.
Go to the park in the morning, exactly.
Puedo contestar con yes, ¿verdad?
Yes. Ahí va a depender de cómo le hacen la pregunta. Por ejemplo, si yo le digo you go to the park, entonces usted me dice yes, I go to the park in the morning. Pero si yo le pregunto what, when do you go to the park, en ese caso solo me dice I go to the park in the morning sin el yes. De ahí va a depender. Vamos a ver acá. Luis watches TV after class, but I don't, ¿verdad? I don't watch TV after class. He watches TV after class, but I don't watch TV after class. I sleep. I don't watch TV after class. Yeah?
Yeah.
No sé si tiene alguna otra pregunta.
No, teacher, creo que estamos ahí.
Estamos bien. Vaya, pues cuídese mucho, oye.
Gracias, teacher.
Cuídese
mucho. Te agradezco mucho también por ayudarme.
Claro. Y que siga mejorcita.
Gracias.
Una bufandita le ayudaría también. Sí. Ay, amigo, me encantan las bufandas.
Sí, a mí me soy un poco alérgica, entonces por eso siento que se me ha quedado.
Sí, no, ya va a estar bien, ya va a estar bien.
Gracias, teacher. Hasta mañana.
Hasta mañana. Bye bye. Take
care. Bye bye. Good night.
Thank you. Good night to you too.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.